Hello friends, today we'll study HTML forms. HTML form is very important. HTML form is used to collect user input. HTML form is used to collect user input. The user input is most often sent to a server for processing. Okay. The user input is most often sent to server for processing. If you want to create email ID, you need to fill the form. Okay, in that you have to fill the user data. Okay, if you want to do any reservation, you need to fill the form. Okay, so for to create such websites, okay, to create some web pages, this HTML form is very important. See, for example, you want to enter first name, then last name. Okay, you want to create such boxes. Okay, and labels. Okay, then when you click submit, you should submit to the server. Okay, like this. This is one example of HTML form. Okay, even in a login form also, you enter username. Okay, then you enter password. Then you click submit. If it is covered, it open your email ID. Okay, enter it to the inbox. The HTML form element is used to create an HTML form for user input. Whatever the HTML form you create, you have to write within form tag. Okay, form open, form close. Within that, you have to write the code of related to HTML form. The form element is a container for different types of input elements. Such as text boxes, you need text boxes to write the name, username, all those things, for your password, etc. Check boxes, you want to need to select the radio buttons, okay, translate any one option, then submit buttons, etc. Okay, including that some drop down option also is there. The input element. The HTML input element is the most used form element. Okay, input element is one of the most used form element. The input element can be displayed in many ways depending on the type of attribute. So here some examples are there. Okay, so first one, input type equal to text. Okay, if you write input type equal to text, it create text box. Okay, displays a single line text input field. Then input type equal to, if you write password, it displays password. Okay, input type equal to radio, displays a radio button for selecting one of many choices. There are many choices out there, you want to select any one option. Okay, then you write input type equal to radio. Then input type equal to checkbox, displays a checkbox for selecting zero or more of many choices. If you want to select maybe one choice, maybe two choice, maybe three choice, any number of choice. Okay, but the radio is to select for only one option, only one choice. But in a checkbox, so you can select 1, 2, 3, any number of choice. Then submit. Displays a submit button for submitting the form. After filling the form, you need to submit that form. So for that you need a submit button. Then input type equal to button. Okay, select, displays a clickable button. Okay, so when you click this button, it should happen. When you, some example, okay, cancel, okay, so save. Okay, so such buttons are very helpful. So we'll study one by one. First one, text field. The input type equal to text defines a single line input field for text input. Okay, the input type equal to text defines single line input field for text input. See, for example, a form with input field for text. Okay, so form, first you have to write form. Okay, so within this form, form open, form close, within that you have to write the code label. For, you can, instead of for, you can write id also, id equal to fname, or for equal to fname, first name. It displays the label first name. Okay, label open, label close. Then br means break. Okay, next line, it displays the next line, next sentence, it displays next sentence. next line, input type equal to text, you need a text box. Id is equal to fname. Id is what? Fname. Name is equal to fname. Then br. Okay, br means break. Label next first name over, next last name. Same label for, or id is equal to lname. Then last name. Then label close br. Then input type equal to text. Okay, this is label. Okay, displays a last name. Then you want text box. So for that, input type equal to text. Id is equal to lname. Here id is fname, id is lname. Then name is equal to lname. Okay, you can give any name, but if you give related, it's better to understand. Okay. Then form open, form close. Okay, we'll execute this part. Okay, if you want to notepad, just right click, open with notepad. So these are the common text, common code. Okay, so after body, okay, you want form. Okay, write form, then label, first name, last name, then text boxes. Okay, one text box for to enter first name, one more text box for to enter last name. Click save. Okay, file name is HTML form. You have to save it .html. HTML form .html. You just double click it. So title name is what? HTML form here. So here title is HTML form. So it displays title as HTML form. Okay. So here heading is HTML form. Okay. So the label is first name. Then text box. You can write the name here. Okay. Here last name you can write. Okay, like this. So this is about the text box. Okay. So this is about the text box, text field. You can enter the, you can enter name, first name and last name. Okay, suppose if you write if you want password, assume. Okay, if you want password. Okay, so here you have to type password instead of text. If you want password, it should not display. Okay, instead of last name, you want password. Okay, then click save. Here name you can write password. Okay, click save, then click refresh. Okay, so it displays password. Okay, password whatever you type, it not displays. Okay, so first name whatever you type, it displays. Okay, like this. You just have to change what? Input type equal to password. If you want password, input type equal to password. Okay, this is about the text field. Next. Okay, note that the form itself is not visible. Also note that the default width of an input field is 20 characters. By default, the length is 20. You can enter 20 characters in that box. Next, the label element. You already applied label in previous example. Okay, notice the use of label element in the example above. The label tag defines the label for many form elements. Okay, so here the first name, password, these all are what? Labels. The labeled element is useful for screen reader users because the screen reader will read out loud the label when the user when the user focus on the input element. Okay, so this label is very helpful. Okay, to identify what you have to type. Okay, if for example here, okay, without this label, it will be very difficult to understand here how to type first name here. Okay, without this label password, okay, very difficult to understand what to type here. So label is very important. The label element also helps the users who have difficulty clicking on very small regions such as the radio buttons or checkboxes. Okay, so it's very helpful to user to who have difficulty clicking on very small regions, because when the user clicks the text within the label element, it toggles the radio button, checkbox. Okay, radio button or checkbox. Okay, so label is very important to identify what you have to do, all those things. The for attribute of the label tag should be equal to the ID attribute of the input element to bind them together. Okay, the for attribute of the label tag should be equal to the ID attribute of the input element. Okay, so for attribute and ID attribute should be equal to bind them together. Okay, next, radio buttons. The input type equal to radio defines a radio button. Okay, if you write input type equal to radio, defines what? A radio button. Radio buttons let a user select one of a limited number of choices. Okay, radio button let user to select one of limited number of choices. There are many choices out there. You want to select only one. You can't select more than one. Example, form. Input type equal to video, ID is equal to male, name equal to gender, value equal to male. Okay, label for equal to male, then male. Okay, then label close. So label here is male. Okay, then br, next line, br means break. Okay, this is about the male. Next, same way, same sentence. Okay, instead of male, female. Okay, name is same, name must be same. Okay, value get change, ID get change, then female. Okay, then one more option, same sentence. Okay, so ID get change, name is same. Okay, ID and value get change. Okay, and label get change, male, female, other. There are three options, you have to select any one. Okay, just to okay, so here radio button, after first name, password, then the radio button. Okay, gender, male, female. Okay, save and click refresh. So it displays what? Male, female. Gender. View BR tag. Gender, you take it before gender, you write BR here. Just save, then click refresh. Okay, so here gender, male, female, other. Okay, you can select anyone. If you select male, then if you select female, male get answer. Okay, so you can select anyone here. Okay, so radio button, you can select any one option. Okay, next, checkboxes. Okay, so the difference between the radio button and checkbox is, okay, radio button displays with circle, checkbox with square. But in the radio button, you can select any only one option, but in checkbox you can select 1, 2, 3, any number of options. The input type equal to checkbox defines a checkbox. Checkboxes let a user to select zero or more options of a limited number of choices. You can select any number of options here. So here input type equal to checkbox, ID is equal to vehicle 1, name equal to vehicle 1, value is equal to bike. Okay, there are three vehicles are there, bike, car and boat. So which one you want? I have a bike, I have a car, I have a boat. Okay. Give BR here so that it display in the next line. Okay, click save. Click refresh. Okay, I have a bike. I have a car. You can select one option or two options also. Okay, I have a bike. We are not close here. Okay, so here you can select one option, two option, or three options. If you click again, it gets unchecked. You can select one, or you can select two, you can select all. Okay, or you can leave also. Okay, so this is about the checkbox. Next to the submit button. The input type equal to submit defines a button for submitting the form data to a form handler. Okay, if you want to submit the data, okay, to a form handler, then you need submit button. The form handler is typically a file on the server with a script for processing input data. Okay, after filling the form, you need to submit. Okay, the form handler is specified in the form of action attribute. So for example, okay, we will create one more separate form. So here our first name is there, last name is there, and submit button is there. Okay, so I'll create one more form. Okay, that form is closed. So here form action. So when you click submit, it submit to this action page.php file. Okay, so here first name, okay, John, last name John. If you want to change, you can change. Okay, you can change the then click submit. Okay, like this. So it submit to that form. So internet is not connected here. So this is how to submit the form. Okay, when you click, it submit to that action.php file. What you are submitting, F name is Ashok and L name is Kumar. Okay, so this is about the submit button. The name attribute for input. Notice that each input field must have a name attribute to be submitted. Okay.